Here, I'm going to show you guys how to make simple email links in Excel. And it works like this. We click the link and we get an email generated with a from to CC BCC subject and a simple message. And the beautiful part about this is we can control all of this from a simple formula in the worksheet. As well as a simple formula, I'm going to show you how to make a button to do the same thing, or almost the same. So we click it. And we get a nice little email pre-made. And we have a few different things that we're going to be doing in this tutorial to achieve this. So let me go ahead and clear everything out and let's get started. Now we're going to start off with a very simple way to do it and then get a bit more advanced and more interesting. So let's give our very interesting employees their email addresses, starting with Michael Scott. Let's go m.scott@test.com and r.deckard, and with a newer version of Excel, it's going to say, hey, I see a pattern, so I'm going to go ahead and see if you want to fill that in or not, and I do, so I'm going to hit enter, and look at that beautiful list, and it recognizes them as an email, so I can go ahead and click that guy, and it's going to open up a very basic, simple email template with the from and the to, and nothing else. So that's the most simple, basic version. Now, one thing that's very important to note is that I'm in Outlook right now. Excel and newer versions of Windows might open you up in their Mail app, which can be very annoying for those of us who pretty much live in Outlook all day. If you want to change that, simply go down to your Windows search bar in the bottom left of your computer or click the Start button or whatever version of Windows you're on, go to where you can search for something, and type Default Apps. So just a simple word or two words, default apps. And then click the app that appears for that and look towards the top. You're going to see email. Click that and change it to Outlook. Then when you click anything that it thinks is an email here in Excel, it's going to open a little window like this in Outlook. Once you've done that, come back here and let's finish this guy up. And no, I do not want to save changes. We are done with a very simple method. So let's go ahead and add a button. I love that we can do this. And once you add some VBA to this, you could automate this process. And automating shapes with VBA is such a fun thing to do. A little bit involved, but fun. So let's type contact Michael Scott right here. And let's go home and center that guy. And of course, in my full VBA course, I tell you all about adding and using and manipulating shapes with VBA. So once we have our shape, our button, it doesn't really fit in with this scheme right here, but if you had very big rows, it could fit in. You could put the button right in the row and center everything. You could make it look nice. So you right-click the button, and then we go to link. And for email address, just start typing m. dot, and when you do that, it's going to put the mail to colon in front of it. Don't worry about that. You do need that. So m.scott@test.com message for Michael. And if you've already input a few of these, it's going to have a line for each one of them down here. So you could just click it and have it auto-fill this in. The syntax down here looks goofy, but we're going to cover that in just a moment. Now from this window, you can also add a screen tip. So send an email to Michael Scott. Okay. Okay. Click away. Hover over it. Send an email to Michael Scott. Click the button. There we go. And this time we get a subject as well as a from and a to. So we are getting there. Now, let's get this button out of the way and continue. So let's go here and go contact and go like this by hand. Okay. And let's go give a little text here. Message ampersand Michael Scott. Down we fill it. And we can right click and go to a link, which is off the screen right now. And we can fill an email address, subject, screen tip, or just click down here. have it fill in for us. Hit OK. And now we have some text for this. And this is a very simple but tedious way to do everything. So let us use a formula. And the formula is going to give us a bit more control. So we can add the CC and the BCC, as well as a very simple body text. And we will be using a formula, so let's add some more pieces to this puzzle. How about a column for subject? How about a column for body? And how about a column for contact, where we will input a formula? And I'm going to show you the very basic version of this formula first, and then we'll make it a lot more interesting. We're going to be using the hyperlink formula. So there is actually a way that we can make a link that's for an email link. And all we have to do is to get the format of that correct here for the link location argument, and then it's going to work. Now let's start with the most basic version of it. So in quotation marks, write mail to colon. And let's just input the email here. So m.scott@test.com. Close that up, then comma, and display text. Close that up, enter. There we go. Here's our display. It's supposed to say text. So let's go here, text. And when I click this guy, we get our basic email set up with a from and the to. Now let's add the other elements. Now what we are going to do is to add a line breaks. So let's go in front of this and hit Alt, enter. It's not going to mess anything up. It's just going to make it easier to read. And let's go right, where should we do it? Right in front of this, Alt, enter. And let's go right here and go space, ampersand, Alt, enter. And we add the additional pieces of the puzzle now. So quotation mark, the very first thing that we want to do is a question mark. And then we're going to type CC equals. Now all of this is optional, but let's say CC equals, and who do we want to carbon copy? Well, let's carbon copy manager1@test.com, and how about manager2 as well? So we do a semicolon manager2@test.com, close that up, space, ampersand, Alt, enter, quote. And this time we want an ampersand. So and BCC equals, maybe let's let Mr. Tyrell know what's going on. Tyrell@test.com, close that up, space, ampersand, Alt, enter, quote, and subject equals sales update. Close that, ampersand, Alt, enter, quote, and body equals, let's just say, an update on your sales progress. Now you can't have too much text here. You're not going to be able to use HTML. You're not going to be able to add attachments to it using this link. You can do all of that after you click the link and you get the little email window, but you can't do it automatically just by clicking this. If you want to do that, check the link below this video for my full course on emails using VBA, where you can do so much stuff. Once you learn how to do that, you might not even want to use the hyperlinks anymore, because it's so cool to be able to add things like attachments automatically with the click of a button. But we're done with our very simple body message and update on your sales progress period. Close that guy up. And let's go ahead, actually, and put the comma here. So we are done. We've got our CCBCC subject body. No more to put in here. So let's do a comma to go to the next argument. But I did put it on the next line as well, so I'm going to remove that. And here is our final, full, complete hard-coded formula in there. Hit enter, click it, and here we have all of it. The full big guy filled out, ready for us to add an attachment by hand or add some more values down here or whatever we want to do with it. And you could stop there. That could be it. But let's go ahead and make this a bit more dynamic so that it changes for each one of the employees. And And I am just going to paste in some of the stuff right down here, a little email template. And you could put this on its own worksheet if you wanted to, and then hide it later so that no one can see it. You can do all sorts of things. I'm going to keep it on the same worksheet so it's easier to see. So this is the email template. And let's get the helper text out of the way. It's not part of this tutorial, just a little note. And here we have our subject, sales update 4, and we're going to put the person's name after that. The body, we're going to put their name before that, then comma, and all of this. Then we have our CC and our BCC, so manager 1. And remember to separate it with a semicolon. And this one's going to Thanos. Let's go ahead and change that from Thanos to Tyrell, since he's no longer in our list. E Tyrell. There we go. And I'm going to go ahead and right-click this and go to the end of the little window, which is off the screen, and click Remove Hyperlink. I don't like that in there if I don't want to click it. And let's go ahead and get our subject ready. So subject we want equals this guy. Hit F4 to dollar sign it, so it's not going to change when we copy it down. Ampersand sales update 4. The name, Control Enter, and double click to copy it down. All right, looks good. Now let's go for the body equals this guy. Ampersand body and F4 for the dollar signs, Control Enter, double click. All right, nice, slightly personalized, just enough so that our employees won't leave. And we have our email template. Okay, everything looks good, some formulas. Now let us make this guy a bit more dynamic. So F2 to open that up. All right, mail to, who do we want to mail this guy to? Let us clear that out of the way. And we need another ampersand, and we are going to mail it to D4. Okay, and for the CC, get that out. And we go down here and we hit F4 so that it won't change when we copy it down. Get Tyrell out of there. And down here, F4. When it becomes tedious, go slow. We're going right here. And right here. And let us change display text to message space quote ampersand space the name. Control Enter. Copy that guy down. Beautiful. All right, now let's give Miss Pris a little email. From to Pris Stratton, manager 1, manager 2, semicolon in the middle. BCC Tyrell, sales update for Pris Stratton. Oh, we forgot a space right there. Time to go add that. Pris Stratton, here's an update on your sales progress. I'm pretty sure she would be a very good salesperson. Very persuasive. And let's just add the space right here. I'm surprised no one has ever commented on the salespeople that I use, by the way, except for maybe Michael Scott. Now let's try it again. And there we have our space. Everything looks good. And let me leave you looking at the link. How about for Deckard? There we go. A simple hyperlink formula. Although the syntax, yes, it's a little bit confusing, but here's what you should do. Copy this guy once, have it in this form so it's much, much easier to read than having it all in one single line. Remember Alt-Enter to make separate lines, and then you can make these relatively easily. And if you want to make more advanced versions of this, then you're going to need a VBA, and I've got a full course that shows you how to do so many cool things, from automatically adding attachments and sending emails, to adding signatures and using HTML in the body of the email so you can make a really nice and professional looking email and have it sent from Excel via Outlook. But for this tutorial, that's all there is. I hope you guys have a great week.